Bangme manasi pratishthitam, mnome vache pratishthitam, abir abir mayedhi, vedaishamanestha, shrutang me ma prahasi ranena ditena ratram samdadami, ritam vadishyami, sittam vadishyami, tanmam abatu, tad bhaktaram abatu, abatumam, abatu bhaktaram, om shanti shanti shanti. Peace mantra from the Rig Veda. May my speech be one with my mind, and may my mind be one with my speech. O thou self-luminous Brahman, remove the veil of ignorance from before me, so that I may behold thy light. Do thou reveal to me the spirit of the scriptures. May the truth of the scriptures be ever present to me. May I seek day and night to realize what I learned from the sages. May I speak the truth of Brahman. May it protect me. May it protect my teacher. Om, peace, peace, peace be unto all. This morning our subject is Stories of Vedanta Monks, Part 29. Life means struggle. Human beings are fighting with six invisible enemies all the time. Lust, anger, greed, delusion, ego, and jealousy. They are invisible. So now we are fighting against another invisible enemy, Corona. We don't know when this enemy will be defeated. People are passing their days through fear and anxiety. It seems the whole world has been paralyzed. For our safety, government locked down, and we are also homebound. Sometimes I watch when I read the newspaper how this invisible enemy grounded thousands and thousands of aeroplanes all over this United States and also in the whole world. Millions of people are not working. All industries are heavily affected. People have no job, no food. Some people have no food. One of our devotees in New York raising some money to help some poor people in Bangladesh and India. I also support them and help them. During this period, it is extremely important to help each other. Jesus said, love thy neighbor as thyself. Only this verbal love is not enough. Love manifests through action, through service. The person you love, you want to serve them. You want to give away everything to your beloved. I remember, who is your true friend? When we are in seventh grade, we used to memorize Hitopadesha. Utsave vyasane chaiva durvikshe rashtra viplave rajadare smasane cha jatishchati sabandava. The person who stands beside you, utsave, at the time of festivity, vyasane, your good time, durvikshe, during famine, rashtra viplave, war, Rajadhari, when you were arrested. Smashani, when somebody died in your family. If the person comes and helps you, stands with you, that person is a true friend. Though this is a critical time, we now find out who is our true friends. How this disease can affect humanity. Not only this disease is killing people, it is breaking the family life. I read in the paper, in China, thousands of people are now filing divorce. Children are at home, they are restless. Sports, entertainment industries are all stopped. We don't see the light at the end of the tunnel. So what shall we do? Last time I told you my suggestions. We shall not misuse the precious time of our lives. Do some work at home. Clean the house, paint the house, reorganize your things, read some inspiring books, do some exercise, walk, practice yoga. Sometimes in Laguna, when I cook, I play some music. Very good thing. One of my students gave me a CD, John Denver's. I love Rocky Mountain High, Colorado. Very beautiful music. I listen also many Indian musics also. Anyhow, make the life interesting, that's all. How can we make our life interesting? Sri Ramakrishna mentioned five things. First, sadhu sangha, have the company of the holy. Second, sadasad vichar, learn how to discriminate between the real and the unreal. Third, ishwari namgunagan, chant God's name. Repeat your mantra, meditate. Majhavaje nirjanvas, sometimes go to solitude and think of the Lord. Learn how to be detached from this world. Fifth, bhagulata, yearning, longing for God. Seeing the setting sun from the Panchabhuti, Sri Ramakrishna would cry, Mother, another day is gone in vain, still thou art not revealed unto me. Longing. Longing is the yearning, longing, hunger for God is the green signal. When the sun, before rising, the eastern horizon becomes golden. That indicates the sun will rise very soon. Similarly, if you have longing, that means your God realization is very near. The topic I already mentioned, Prachin Sadhudir Katha, stories of the Vedanta monks of the Ramakrishna Order. It is a series of talk based on the reminiscences of the second generation of Ramakrishna monks. Sri Ramakrishna is our source, origin. Then he trained his 16 monastic disciples and devotees. We have not seen Ramakrishna, we have not seen the Jari disciples. But we saw the second generation, those who were trained by Sri Ramakrishna's disciples and Holy Mother. And we are the third generation. This second generation monk and about the Jari disciples. They are the witness of the blazing fire of renunciation and purity. Their love and compassion, their devotion, their spiritual experiences, and how they served humanity. I tried to collect all their reminiscences over the period of 60 years and put them in these two volumes, Prachin Shadudir Katha. This is the volume two. These stories came from my from my reminiscences, from my diaries, from my interviews, from my tapes. And I also got many diaries of monks who now passed away. And also many articles. We collected over 120 monks' stories and reminiscences in this book, in these two volumes. Monks' life is very difficult, so the householder's life. Sri Ramakrishna made two models. Ideal monks like Vivekananda, Brahmananda, Premananda, Shivananda, and ideal householders like Nagmahashay, A.M. Srimo, Balaram Bosu, ideal women, disciples also, Yoginma, Gulapma, Gaurima. Model. Model is very, very important. In America, they make a model of a car. Then they experiment it. Then when they see this model is working right, they make all the parts. And that car goes to the assembly lines in Detroit or some other places. And all these cars come out. If the model is defective, these millions of cars will be defective. So model is very, very important in your spiritual life. A monk's life should be a model. Model must be perfect. Swami Vivekananda defined religion. Religion is the manifestation of perfection already in human beings. Perfection. We want to be perfect. We love perfection. We want a perfect guru, perfect disciple, perfect husband, perfect wife, perfect mother, perfect father, perfect children, perfect doctor. That very perfection is inherent in human beings. Perfect. We have come in this world to attain that perfection. Swami Turiyananda used to say, Swamiji was a perfect human being. He was perfect in every respect. Perfection. Let me tell you a funny story I heard from radio. It is a village church, a pastor, minister came and gave a sermon, and he challenged the audience. Only God is perfect. Nobody is perfect. Then he challenged the audience, is there anybody in this congregation perfect? Raise your hand. Nobody raised the hand. Have you seen anybody perfect? Raise your hand. Nobody raised the hand. Have you heard anybody perfect? Raise your hand. So one man from the back raised his hand. The minister was very mad at him and said, are you perfect? No, sir. Have you seen anybody perfect? No, sir. Have you heard anybody perfect? Yes, sir. Who? My wife's first husband. Funny. I could not understand. I asked somebody, but you could not follow that American joke, that humor. Whatever this man does, the wife says, my first husband was better than this. So this poor fellow came to the church, faced the same challenge, and understood what is perfect. Funny. Now let me start the reminiscences of Swami Sambhidananda. This Swami was a disciple of Holy Mother. He came from Maimansing from Bangladesh and got sannyas from Swami Brahmananda. And he started a center in Chandanagar. Last time I did half of his reminiscences, the other half I shall tell you now. He was talking about monk's life. The monastic life is very slippery. Your one minute's mistake, one moment's mistake, can ruin your whole life. It is just like you are climbing on the top of the Himalayas, of the Mount Everest, 29,000 feet. One false step will bring you down in no time. So this monastic life, the Upanishad says, Kshurasya dhara nishita durattaya durgam patasdat kavayu vadanti. Kshurasya dhara, it is as if you were working on the sharp edge of a razor. It may cut at any moment. You must be very careful. Monastic life. The Swami was talking about a monk who went to Mussoorie Hills for practicing austerity. But there he had some problem. He fell, he has some lapses. So he came back to the monastery and confessed his mistake to Swami Sivananda and Swami Sharadananda. Both Swamis listened to his story. They said, Sri Ramakrishna brought you to the monastery. Some people think that you should be out from the order. But we have no right to throw you out. Let us give you a suggestion. You go to Rishikesh and practice some austerity. Then again you come back. Time to time, by momentary infatuation, people make some mistakes. That doesn't mean your whole life is gone forever. A child when starts walking, how many times the child falls before the child learns to walk? So once you fall, then don't think that is the that is the end of your life. After every fall, you must rise. That is a beautiful way the Swami said, we observe these direct disciples, how much love and compassion had for the monks. There was another Swami Chokku Maharaj, Swami Yadavananda. He was an attendant of Swami Turiyananda. One night he went to see a dance performance. Next morning, Swami Turiyananda asked him, Chokku, why did you go? Maharaj, I went to see a dance performance. Why did you not ask me? Maharaj, if I would ask you, you would not let me go. Maharaj was very pleased. He told the Mohanto of that center, this monk has some good stuff inside, though he is very indisciplined, very rough exterior, but he is a good person. He is very sincere, but indisciplined. The Swami writes that how the Jari disciples would bring some raw materials and how they used to try to shape them, make them perfect. I remember when I first came to Hollywood, Swami Prabhupada said, Chaitananda, it is not a, there is no glory to make a good man good. If you can make a bad man good, then you have, there is a glory, there is a credit. Don't think that Narada and Sukadeva will come to you to learn Vedanta. These American people will come, teach them Vedanta. Sri Ramakrishna said, human beings make mistakes. One Swami also mentioned that Sri Ramakrishna forgives 99 times. When 100 times comes, he takes action. He forgives and forgives. We make so many mistakes in our lives. We are not perfect. When this Chokku Maharaj is very difficult to handle in the monastery. So he asked Swami Sambhidananda that you are going to Rangoon, I would like to go with you. So he agreed. Sharadananda told him, you will not be able to handle him. He is a very difficult person. He will stay with me in Udbodhan. You see, Udbodhan was the place where the monks who could not adjust with others or have any problems, they used to come and take shelter with Holy Mother and Swami Sharadananda. So Udbodhan was Khapar Haj Bazar. It was the marketplace of the crazy people. And Sharadananda used to take care of them. Sometimes people may think that about monastic life, sometimes we have difference of opinion. In the working field, about our ideal goal, no differences. Sri Ramakrishna was our ideal, Sri Ramakrishna was our goal. But the working field, yes, we have difference of opinion. I think this thing should be this way. Another person says, no, this should be this way. It is all opinions of different people. That is the reason Swamiji made this democracy. Joint opinion should be accepted. Majority opinion should be accepted. That is the way Ramakrishna Mission functions. Anyhow, we in the monastery, sometimes we had problems. Householders' life also have problems. I sometimes say, husband and wife, sometimes they had quarrel. That doesn't mean I give an example. Suppose in the sink you are washing your cups and plates. If some make some noise, that doesn't mean you will have to break all cups and plates. Sometimes our tongue is cut by the teeth, but doesn't mean you will need a hammer and break all your teeth. We'll have to adjust. We'll have to live together. That's all. Adjustment is very, very important. Look how Sri Ramakrishna taught Holy Mother. Jokon jamon তখন তেমন, যেখানে যেমন সেখানে তেমন, যাকে যেমন তাকে তেমন। ইট ইজ এ গ্রেট 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 মেসেজ ইন দিস এজ। অ্যাডজাস্ট অ্যাকর্ডিং টু পার্সন, অ্যাডজাস্ট অ্যাকর্ডিং টু টাইম, অ্যাডজাস্ট অ্যাকর্ডিং টু প্লেস। ইট ইজ এক্সট্রিমলি ইম্পর্ট্যান্ট। উইল হ্যাভ টু লিভ টুগেদার। I remember a funny story. I was in the hospital in 1966 in the School of Tropical Medicine. So one of our devotee doctors, he used to come and greet me every day. He used to call me holy man. Hello, holy man, do you know what is called married life? Uncle, I have no experience. Then he said, listen, he was a widower, lost his wife. First year, husband speaks, wife listens. Second year, wife speaks, husband listens. And third year, both speak, neighbors listen. That is called married life. He was a very funny man. But you know, Holy Mother is very, very particular. If a monk once has any desire to have a family life, Mother said, please go. Get married, have a family life. Do not tarnish the goodwill, the greatness of this Ramakrishna order. This order is very pure. These monks follow Ramakrishna's ideal. Do not pollute this order. Holy Mother was very, very particular about it. St. Paul made a remark, it is better marry than to burn. We are talking about friction in the monastery. Swami Sambhidananda wrote, Swami Umananda and Kishori Maharaj, Swami Parameshwarananda, was a mother's disciple, head of Jayarambati. I met him many times from 1961. So these two Swamis had some friction, and both wrote to Swami Sarodananda, who was the general secretary. So one Swami came and complained, Umananda. Swami asked him, the thing which you are telling me, that thing did you tell the head Swami? Then he wrote a letter, you know, listen, I am supposed to go and do that work, but it is my old age, and I am in Calcutta, I have to maintain, do this general secretary's work. That is the reason I asked you to do that work there. Please reconcile. Do not quarrel and do the work right way. Have some understanding between both of you. And Swami Sarodananda, what he would do, suppose you complain against a monk, he will write, I am sending your letter to him, and his letter he will send to him. Later on, the quarreling will stop. Oh, yeah, I remember Buddha Maharaj in Benares. If somebody comes, he was the head Swami. If somebody comes and complains against another monk, he will say, hey, he will call the other monk, hey, this thing this monk told you about you. So later on, they understood that he cannot keep anything in his stomach, so nobody would complain against anybody. Another monk told me, very funny, I'm just telling you that, you know, don't think we are, there is no friction in the monastery. A monk came and complained. The head Swami said, you are complaining against him? There are many complaints against you also. There was another Swami. He was an attendant of Swami Brahmananda. And he made a mistake, so it was decided that he should be out from the order. Then Swami Brahmananda, in the trustee meeting, I heard this story, was asking, all right. The next day, Swami Brahmananda resigned and gave the letter to Sharadananda, when I resigned from general presidency. Why, Maharaj? Oh, no, if I cannot make that monk change his life, I should not be a president. No, Maharaj, if you want him, keep him here, your attendant, you keep him here, whatever you want, that is fine. What we learn from these stories, these direct disciples could change the lives of these people through love, through affection, through feeling. He could remove their bad karma. Somebody says that Swamiji was Putit Pavan, savior of the fallen. Swami Brahmananda says, I am also the savior of the fallen. There is one, there's a story I shall tell you later, that Tabu, Motishar Sen, Boshishar Sen's brother, he made some mistake and avoided. He was very fond of Swami Brahmananda. Brahmananda was very fond of him. He avoided Brahmananda. One noon at Balaram Mandir, he came. Maharaj saw him from a distance. Tabo, Maharaj, come here. He was afraid to come near him. Tabu, have you seen the water buffalo? Yes, Maharaj. Did you see it has big horn? Yes, Maharaj. If a mosquito sits on the horn, does the buffalo feel? He kept quiet. But I am that water buffalo. The water buffalo does not feel the weight of a mosquito on the horn. A little mistake you have made, I don't mind. Come to me. How these disciples of Ramakrishna would change the people. August 3, 1953. It was in 1922, Swami Brahmananda passed away. Swami Sivananda became the president. And Sharadananda, of course, remained the general secretary. So Brahmananda died, all are very grief-stricken. There was a governing body, trustee meeting in Belur Math. Mahapurush Maharaj will be the president in that meeting. Sharadananda refused to be the president, though he got the maximum vote. Swami Sambhidananda wrote, I went with Swami Sharadananda from Udbodhan to Belur Math to attend that then meeting. After the meeting, from upstairs, Sharadananda came downstairs and asked him, hey, bring some smoke. So he was smoking his apple bubble. Then Sharadananda made a remark, Baba, khub beche geyechi. President kore felechilo ar ki. I am saved by the grace of Sri Ramakrishna. They have almost made me the president of the order. You know, this kind of statement shows the disciples of Ramakrishna have no desire to have the position. I want to be the president of the order. He is relieved that he was not president of the order. He got the maximum vote. They met Swami Sivananda president. But then another day, there was a governing body meeting. I went with Sharadananda. He was the attendant of Sharadananda. And we went to the visitor's room in that meeting. There are two special seats, one for Swami Sivananda, another for Swami Sharadananda. And other trustees are, of course, will be there. So Swami Sharadananda asked me, please call Swami Sivananda ji, he is upstairs. So I went there. Swami Sambhidananda writes. Then Mahapurush Maharaj, Swami Sivananda was telling, oh, meeting. But I am not the president. Maharaj is the president. So make one asana, one seat for Maharaj in that meeting. So he took one seat and put it there, one carpet. So Swami Sarvadharananda is asking, what are you doing? Whose carpet is that? Well, Mahapurush Maharaj said, there should be one seat for Swami Brahmananda. Swami Sarvadharananda kept quiet. Then the meeting, Swami Sivananda came, sat in his seat, and then meeting continued. This kind of life, it shows that how much love and respect they had for the senior monks of the Ramakrishna Order, especially the Jari disciples. You see, mutual love and mutual respect is very vital for an organization. Rules and regulations cannot bring unity. Swami Sambhidananda mentioned renunciation of the Jari disciple. Mrs. Olibul left 50,000 rupees for Belur Math in her will. Her brother, Mr. Thrapp, was the executor of that will. But her daughter, Olia, demanded that money. Oh, my mother's mind toward the end was not right, you know. He used to meditate, burn incense. He was not mentally normal. Belur Math easily could get that money. Brahmananda refused. He said, Swamiji would love and respect Mrs. Olibul like his mother, and her daughter wants that money. Let her have that money. We don't want it. In those days, 50,000 rupees, and Belur Math was not in a, financially was not very sound at that time. Look, their renunciation. Swami wrote, in the Mayabati account, Mrs. Xavier had 20,000 rupees. It was supposed to come to Ramakrishna Order. But when she was returning to England, she wanted that money back. Swami Brahmananda immediately said, yes, please take your money. Legally, he could not take that money. The Swami told you another story. There was a businessman, Mahesh Chandra Bhattacharya. He has homeopathic medicine shop, very famous businessman. His wife died. I think he has no children. He came to Belur Math and stayed and offered all his wealth to Belur Math. Swami Premananda was eager to accept his offer, but Brahmananda refused. Brahmananda told Premananda, brother, a householder wants to renounce, and being monks, we are one to have that money. It is not right. After some days, his renunciation did not last. He went back and started his business again. Swami Sambhidananda mentioned. It was during Durga Puja. After Durga Puja, you know, Vijaya, the monks are singing and they drank some marijuana syrup, what is called Shiddhi. And they are singing Khapar Haj Bajar, Matudir Khapar Haj Bajar, Gunir Kotha Kavokar. তোরা দুই সতীনে কেউ বুকে কেউ মাথায় চড়িস তার শ্মশানে আর মশানে ফিরিস কার বা ধরিস ধারিস ধার এবার রামপ্রসাদে কে ভবঘরে করতে হবে পার মাদার দিস ইজ ইউর ক্রেজি মার্কেট If you move in the cremation ground, in this time you will have to save the life of Ramprasad. Ramprasad was the mystic poet. So it is Ramprasad song. So if we are all singing and Kurte have a part, they are all intoxicated. So Mahapurush Maharaj came, Kurte have a part. What do you want to? And he scolded them and these monks stopped. One time we are returning from Banaras to Calcutta. Swami Sharadananda asked me to bring the almanac from the office. He wanted to consult an auspicious day for journey. So I asked him, Maharaj, why do you consult the almanac? The train goes every day with people. They are not empty. Nobody, who cares for the almanac and auspicious day? The train does not go empty. Swami Sharadananda kept quiet for a little while. How do you know that it does not work? Sri Ramakrishna believed this. So we believe it. Whatever Sri Ramakrishna accepted, you people also accept. Jaman Ashlesha, Maga, Barbela, Yogini, Erakum Koti. Anyhow, this is the way the Swami Brahmananda also used to consult the almanac before going any place. Swami Madhavananda also. It so happened, Swami Madhavananda was coming from Mayavati and he consulted the almanac. And on the way, he was riding a horse and he fell down from the horse. And he had some cuts and bruises. So somebody made a remark, Maharaj, you consulted the almanac, look what happened. Maharaj said, you know, because I consulted the almanac, my life is saved. My life is saved. I remember when I was coming to Hollywood, Swami Gumbhiranandaji was asking me, have you consulted the almanac? I go, no, Maharaj. My goodness, you did not consult the almanac. I go, no. If you do not like me, I shall come back. I am going to work for Sri Ramakrishna. He will look after me. In Bangalore, Sadashiva Iyer was a staunch Vaishnava of Shaivites. He was a great devotee of Shoshi Maharaj. Well, he wanted that his guru should be traditional Vaishnavite monk, you know, with vibhuti, rudraksha, and all these things. So one day, Shoshi Maharaj dressed like that and appeared before him, and he was very happy. Once Shoshi Maharaj wanted to show a dancer in South India how Sri Ramakrishna danced. But when Thakur used to sing and dance, sometimes he goes forward and backward. Perhaps you can read that Ramakrishna, they saw him. There, Ramlal Dada, Sri Ramakrishna's nephew, in his reminiscences mentioned Sri Ramakrishna's mode of dancing. But sometimes he used to slap on his thigh. Sometimes he used to walk, move around, move his gesture and posture, how Sri Ramakrishna used to sing and dance. You see, in Bharatanatyam, we have seen that how the mood, expression, comes through the gesture and postures of the body. But when Sri Ramakrishna used to dance, the mood, the feeling would manifest in his body, physical movement. It is an art. In the Sinduriya Potti, Swami Sharadananda mentioned that when Sri Ramakrishna went to attend the Brahma festival, When I saw a current of bliss is going up and down, the devotees are also dancing, the current is down, and when Ramakrishna goes to the peak in Ramakrishna, again it goes down. It is unexpressible. It cannot be expressed. Inexpressible. That how Sri Ramakrishna's gesture and posture and movement and talk. In Varanagar, Swami Ramakrishnananda would worship Sri Ramakrishna with great love and devotion, with all sincerity. In that connection, about the almanac, I must tell another story before I forget. In Belurmath once there was a difference of opinion between two groups of monks. One group said that what Thakur believed, we must believe. Thakur believed all these almanacs, all these dates, auspicious, inauspicious. We must believe it, otherwise we are not Ramakrishna monks. Another group said, we are Atman. We are beyond all this almanac, all the superstitions. They say, Nistrigunne poti vicharatam ko vidhi ko nishidha. Those who tread the path of Nirgun Brahman, all this prohibition and vidhi. Vidhi means conjunction and the prohibition, these things are meaningless, not necessary. So Swamiji was the umpire. Both groups came to Swamiji. Swamiji said, you are right, you are right. How both could be right? Swamiji said, you have faith in Thakur and you want to follow the way Thakur led the life. You are perfect. Go ahead. And you believe the follow of the Nirguna Brahman Atman, that is also right. You follow your path. That is a beautiful way Swamiji reconciled these two groups. Freedom. Love and freedom, these are the two conditions of growth. That Swamiji said again and again. Anyhow, so in Varanagar Monastery, Swami Ramakrishnananda was the worshipper and he used to cook food for Thakur, serve Thakur food. And at that time, they are passing through so much poverty, there is not sufficient food. Swamiji used to criticize, they are worshipping Ramakrishna. Ramakrishna cannot give us food. Ramakrishna, okay. এ শশি তোর রাজ ঠাকুর এখন কী করছেন কি পিঞ্জি চটকাচ্ছেন মানে দ্য রাইস ইউ নো বল হি ইজ মেকিং অল দিস থিং হি ওয়াজ জাস্ট হি ওয়াজ টিজিং অ্যান্ড টু মেক হিম অ্যাঙ্গ্রি অ্যান্ড স্বামীজি এনজয়েজ হিজ অ্যাঙ্গার অ্যান্ড ফ্রাস্ট্রেশন ওয়ান যে শশী মহারাজ ওয়াজ ভেরি অ্যাঙ্গ্রি অ্যান্ড হি পুশড স্বামীজি সো বাট ফোর ও ক্লক ওয়েন দেয়ার ওয়াজ এ বেল হি ওয়েন্ট টু ওপেন দি শ্রাইন And he pushed Swamiji and went to the shrine and Jai Guru, saying so. He raised Thakur and worshipping. When he came out from shrine, Swami Vivekananda bowed down to him. Do you know what he said? Bhai Shoshi, tui shekhali Guru Bhakti kake bole. Brother Shoshi, you demonstrated what is called devotion to the Guru. You know, when I read these stories, do you know how do I feel? How Sri Ramakrishna tired these people with the cord of love. That is the only thing necessary in human life. I told you many times that the story of John, when he became old, he was a direct disciple of Jesus. When he became old, people would bring him to the church, carrying him by in a chair. And people would come and ask, tell us about Jesus. Love one another. Every Sunday he used to say the same thing. Somebody asked, did you not hear anything else? What more to say? Love one another. That we find in the lives of the Jari disciples of Sri Ramakrishna. So much love for each other. Swami Paramananda, who was in America, Swamiji's disciple, wrote a book, Path of Devotion. Those are letters of Swami. Letters of Swami Ramakrishnananda. In Dhaka, Swami Brahmananda was initiating many people. I went and asked, Maharaj, will you initiate me? You are foolish. I shall initiate you in Belur Math. Belur Math is Siddha Peach, Pichosta. That was the story of Swami Sambhidananda. Next is Swami Kripananda in Vrindavan. Raja Maharaj ki one day Swami Sahajananda, another Swami, was fanning Swami Brahmananda. And he was thinking, let me see how much power Swami Brahmananda has. He was trying to think a very bad thought. Let me see whether I can raise a bad thought in my mind or not. 5-7 minutes gone, then Brahmananda looked at him and said, Brahmananda smiled a little bit and said, Ki parli, could you succeed? Then he knew Maharaj was antarjami, all-knowing. I wrote a little bit about my reminiscences of Swami Kripananda. It was in 1959, during Durga Puja. I went for a pilgrimage. First I went to Agra, then Vrindavan, Delhi, Haridwar, Rishikesh, Banaras. So I was in Vrindavan. It was in old ashrama, the new ashrama at that time under construction. It is on the bank of the river Jamuna. We had hospital. So in the guest room, I myself and another Parsi gentleman, he was an engineer from Bombay, was supervising the construction of the new ashrama in Vrindavan. So we are in the same room that old man used to tell me. Got greeted day for work at night for prayer. After coming back from work, he used to pray. Very devout person. I visited all these temples, and Maharaj was very kind to me. Another Swami said, you come and join here in Vrindavan. It is a very holy place, and this Swami is a great Swami. But do you know what happened? I had a pimple here, and next day I'm supposed to go to Delhi. So I was thinking, let me press it. So I pressed it. Overnight, my face swelled. It poisoned. The whole face swelled. Then immediately Maharaj sent me to the hospital. Our hospital. Where Ram Maharaj, he used to give me the injection, penicillin injection. So 1 week I was stuck in Vrindavan. I still remember Maharaj's love and affection for me. Next one is Vasishtha Sen. I met him in 1970, September, in Almora. I met his wife also, Gertrude Emerson Sen. She was a great writer. So I asked Boshi Babu that after you met Swami Brahmananda and you were so close to him, you used to shave him. Now tell me something which I have not heard. something new. Well, one day we are playing cards with Maharaj, and I told Maharaj, Maharaj, you are miserly. Maharaj all of a sudden became very grieved and said, why do you say so? Maharaj, a person who has plenty of money does not give away to the others, he is miser. You have so much spirituality and spiritual power, you can give God realization to others, but you are not giving, so you are miser. Maharaj said, Kechai, who wants God? Look, even the monks come, Maharaj, give me initiation, Maharaj, give me brahmacharya, Maharaj, give me sannyas. They do not, even the monks do not ask, Maharaj, give me God. That's a new thing I heard from him. I went many times to Shivabu's house in Vishnapur. I met him in 1967, Nivedita centenary time. He came to Calcutta in Mahajati Sadhan. He gave lecture. He was very close to Nivedita and Sadananda. 11th September 1952, Almora, Bhushishan's house. Swami Dhirashananda's diary. Bhushi Babu says, you know, people would call us dogs of Swami Sadananda. These two brothers, they used to serve Swami Sadananda, who was Swamiji's first disciple. But sometimes he used to scold us. We could not bear his scolding. Once he said, why don't you go and leave? Swamiji will look after me. But one day in Belur Math, I was rolling the chapati. And Swamiji came and sat on my shoulder. Hey, Gupta, his name, Gupta Maharaj, we used to call him, Sadananda, ask a boon from me. Maharaj, you want to give me a boon? Tell me, Swami, may I never be lokhi chada, mane unfortunate. Swamiji kept quiet. He had a wonderful relationship with his guru. Once in visitor's room, I said, I became a monk, what have I achieved? Swamiji was walking in the veranda. He was in the visitor's room in Belur Math. Swamiji said, Ami ar ki korbo, bol, tor juto porjonto mathay boyechi, ar ki korbo. When he left home, followed Swamiji, he could not walk. Swamiji carried him on his shoulder, on his back, and his bundle on his shoulder. It was sometimes some desert, some places. They were being a guru, I carried your shoes. What else I can do for you? But Gupta Maharaj burst into tears. I think another time he said, if I fall, if you go to hell, I shall go to hell and pull your hair and pull you up. Gupta Maharaj was sick. Holy Mother came to see him. It is a Boshpara house, a small room. We spread a cloth for Holy Mother to sit. Gupta Maharaj said, Mother, put your foot on my head and bless me. Mother did it. Fulfill my desire, Mother. Then he took some flowers and put at Mother's feet and then ate all those flowers. But I watched how much devotion he had for mother. In Jayarambachi Tabu, his brother, his name is Motishar. His name is Boshishar. His brother's name is Motishar. Tabu, nickname. Hey, Tabu, come here, I shall initiate you. No, mother, I don't want initiation. No, you come, I shall initiate you. Mother initiated him. Mother was very fond of that family because that was her halting place in Vishnupur. While coming to Calcutta, to Jayarambachi, or Jayarambachi to Calcutta, Holy Mother used to stop in their house. They have a special room for mother and us. That room is still there. I took many pictures of that house. And Bhulu is Boshi's bhaipo. He was not very, very disciplined, you know, very rough, naughty person. One day Gulappa was asking, Kera, hey, who is there? Holy Mother said, Omar Bhulu, he is my Bhulu. Mani, Samudrishti. Good and bad, all are equal in the eyes of a Nuara Brahman. Bhulu was telling, they used to live in Bagh Bazar. Bhulu was telling Holy Mother, Mother, I shall go to Belur Math to see Durga Puja. Mother said, Kothay jabe? Ami ekhane eshechi, ar kothay jabe? I am here, where will you go? Indirectly she mentioned that I am that Mother Durga. Mother came in our home in Vishnupur, Swami Boshi Babu writes. Boshi, ye barita dekhi, Swami eshechi. Boshi, keep this house. I have come here. Swami Prabhavananda asked Boshi Babu, Prabhavananda is also from Vishnupur. He asked Boshi Babu, that why don't you be a monk? So one day I decided I shall go to Brahmananda and told Maharaj, Maharaj, planning to propose Maharaj that I do want to be a monk. The moment Maharaj saw me, he said, Kire Boshi, tor science ki bole. Maharaj was asking, hey Boshi, what does your science say? Boshi was a scientist. He was very close to Jagadish Chandra Bosu. I gave a lecture on cosmic ray for half an hour. So Maharaj said, Boshi, eta chadishna, eta niyei thak. Don't give up this science. Hold on it. The question arose in my mind, Maharaj solved it. 4th November 1952, evening. Swami Dhirashananda's diary. Swamiji said, Maharaj indicated and Mother gave. Some people would come and sit with Swami Brahmananda. And Maharaj only maintained silence, no talk. And people's answers, questions were answered from within. But what a spiritual power he had. I translated that thing, the Boshi's reminiscences came in the Vedanta and the West magazine in Bengali. What happened when Maharaj was dying, Boshi Babu came and holding the hand, and he was thinking, Maharaj on almost in the coma stage. Whenever I used to shake hands with Maharaj, Maharaj would press it. So this moment, if Maharaj can press my hand, I shall think, Maharaj remember me. Maharaj remembers me. So the moment I put my hand with Maharaj's hand, Maharaj pressed. when the Belvin Bhat Swamiji was telling that, you know, when the march mission and money, whatever Swamiji brought, somebody made a remark that perhaps the disciples may claim these things, that it is my guru's thing. Swamiji told Sadananda, "Hey Gupta, why don't you write down that I have no claim of all these things?" Maharaji, if somebody would say that, I would understand. But you said this, it breaks my heart. You know how much love I have for you. And when you came to me, when I was a station master, you were a beggar. And I used to put shoes worth 25 rupees. I did not come to be a monk seeing your wealth. You are my guru. What guru bhakti he has. In Belur Mart, no fan. Whole night, Gupta Maharaj, Swami Sadananda fan Swamiji. Then, whole night, then he was tired. Then he fell asleep in the veranda. And you know the upper veranda. And each side the sun was coming. Swamiji went to his room and brought an umbrella and protecting the head of the disciple so that he can have a little sleep. You know, these tiny, tiny incidents, episodes, shows what is called real religion. Do you love for people? Do you have feelings for others? That is the way I understood religion. And the Jari disciples demonstrated it. Thank you very much. Atma mei shuddhantam jyotiraham viraja vipappa bhuyasam. Antaratma mei shuddhantam jyotiraham viraja vipappa bhuyasam. Paramatma mei shuddhantam jyotiraham viraja vipappa bhuyasam. Om shanti shanti shanti. May my body become pure. May I be free from impurities and ignorance. May I realize myself as the light divine. May my mind become pure. May I be free from impurities and ignorance. May I realize myself as the light divine. May my soul become pure. May I be free from impurities and ignorance. May I realize myself as the light divine. Om, peace, peace, peace be unto all.